Welcome back to the Daily Poem here on the Close Reads Podcast Network. I'm David Kerr. Today's poem is by William Wordsworth, one of the greatest poets to ever write poetry in the English language. He lived from 1770 to 1850 and was, as you probably know by now, a major English romantic poet and a contemporary of the likes of Samuel Taylor Coleridge. He was Britain's poet laureate from 1843 until his death in 1850. And the poem that I'm going to read today is a sonnet called "It is a Beauteous Evening, Calm and Free." This is how it goes. It is a beauteous evening, calm and free. The holy time is quiet as a nun, breathless with adoration. The broad sun is sinking down in its tranquility. The gentleness of heaven broods o'er the sea. Listen, the mighty being is awake, and doth with his eternal motion make a sound like thunder, everlastingly. Dear child, dear girl that walkest with me here, if thou appear untouched by solemn thought, thy nature is not therefore less divine. Thou liest in Abram's bosom all the year, and worshippest at the temple's inner shrine, God being with thee when we know it not. This poem was written at, well, according to Wikipedia, at Calais in August of 1802, and is a poem about a walk that he took with his 9-year-old daughter. And for what it's worth, apparently, Wordsworth had not written many sonnets up to this point, or had not written any in quite a while, but then his sister Dorothy had recited some of Milton's sonnets, and this had, quote, fired him, and then he went on to write 415 sonnets. This was the only, quote, personal sonnet. A lot of his other sonnets were political in nature. In my opinion, the line, the couplet, "The holy time is quiet as a nun, breathless with adoration," that bit of enjambment there is one of the great lines in all of poetry. I mean, that's the line that you can see being echoed in the work of Robert Frost later, and I think Elizabeth Bishop, and I mean, there's so many poets who are imitating what he does there. I'm not saying Wordsworth was the first to use enjambment or anything like that, but the cadences and the way he brings that image out, the surprise of the image. You get to the end of the first line, "The holy time is quiet as a nun." That's just a great line. But then it turns into breathless with adoration. Because when you get to the end of that line about the nun, you're left wanting more. You're left sort of hungry for what's going to come next. And then breathless with adoration is an incredible image because it's so specific and so tactile and so experienced. I think we all have sensed that idea of being breathless with adoration, whether it's a spiritual thing, or whether it's because you're looking at your child, or you see a sunset, or whatever it is, or you're walking with your daughter and you see something beautiful like this. But one of the things that I love about this poem is the way it transitions from what seems to be just his own reflections to a sort of conversation between him and his daughter. You get to that end where it says, "The gentleness of heaven broods o'er the sea." And then you get an end stop there. Really, it's a semicolon. And then it says, "Listen, the mighty being is awake." And I imagine that being like, he turns to his daughter and he says, "Listen, listen, pay attention to what you're seeing here." And it's like he's calling her into it. And then he finishes there's three more lines. And then he says, "Dear child." And he says, "Dear child, dear girl." Almost as if she doesn't hear him the first time or the second time. And so he has to say, "Dear girl," a third time. And he said, it's almost like he's being exasperated. But then he realizes the fact that she is not responding the way he wants to it, wants her to respond to this beautiful thing that he's seeing. It's not that her nature is less divine. He says that she's at one with nature, so to speak, all the time. She has a childlike wonder. And she it's not so special to her because she sees things like that all the time. It's how she looks at the world. It's about a way of seeing the world. So there's a lot going on in this poem, a lot more than what I've covered here in 2 or 3 minutes. Wordsworth's sister Dorothy in her journals references this visit to Calais. So if you want to dive into that, you can. Wikipedia has some good summaries. You can find things on the internet if you want to learn more about this poem. Another great poem to memorize, by the way. One more time then, here is Wordsworth's "It is Beauteous Evening, Calm and Free." It is a beauteous evening, calm and free. The holy time is quiet as a nun, breathless with adoration. The broad sun is sinking down in its tranquility. The gentleness of heaven broods o'er the sea. Listen, the mighty being is awake, and doth with his eternal motion make a sound like thunder, everlastingly. Dear child, dear girl that walkest with me here, if thou appear untouched by solemn thought, thy nature is not therefore less divine. Thou liest in Abraham's bosom all the year, and worshipst at the temple's inner shrine, God being with thee when we know it not. This has been the Daily Poem. Thanks so much for listening. Be back tomorrow with another poem for you.